Making life worth living in retirement worth having is really about the people in our lives. It's about what we say. It's about what we do. It's about how we interact with others. It's about how we show the Lord of God of all's love through us. And it's about what we do in moments of time. You see, there are moments of time when people lie, steal, and cheat a man from their life. That is true. They literally lie about what someone's doing. They think they have the right to opinion what someone is present for. They openly will pick up a phone and call someone and gossip in a way that harms a person's life. I've seen it happen time and time again, and it really does devalue an individual's life. They play God, if you will, in someone's life. They think they are Lord of all. They sit in a proud way. They sit like a peacock in their uniforms, and they say, "I am in charge here," when in truth, they're really not. The Lord of all will pick and choose the date, the time, and literally the hour in which they leave this earth. They will either leave in an honorable way or they won't, and that's the truth. That people of the lie think they are okay in the Lord because they are lying in their minds to be able to protect what they think is the Lord's plan for someone else's life. And it's not their right to say. They are not God of all. They are not Lord of all things. They are certainly not Lord of every person in their congregation or in their communities. And that's something that some people who are so proud in their religious beliefs and religious practices literally think, that if they make just enough mistakes, they can foul up a person's life. If they continue to violate federal law, they're okay with that. The police allow it. Other people might as well. But is that right? Is it lawful? Is it moral? Not really. Now, when I talk like this, people think I'm not doing anything. They think I'm just joking around. They think I'm telling a story. They think I'm reporting on something not truthful. That's not the truth either. Literally, I can say that without a shadow of a doubt, my technology has been hampered. That every time I make a telephone call, I end up talking to the same man with virtually the same voice, pretending to be a different person. Now, if it's the federal government making a game plan, then that's on them. That's their lie. If it's a local person doing that and infiltrating my technology and thinking they have the right to play a game with my life, that's on them. But in the proudest moments of time, they can believe they're above the law, but they're really not above the law at all. They have violated laws. They have violated mobility. They have violated technology. They have violated communications opportunities. They have violated rights to association. They have violated rights to religion practices. And they literally have violated people's rights to their food being without tainting. Now, let's talk about that. You see, there are people in this world who will walk in and say, "This man is a bad person, so we're going to do this to him to make sure that he doesn't do this to anyone else." But who gave that person the right to do that? Who gave them the right to even say anything about that person's life? And who literally is going to believe that person only if they're in some sort of professional uniform? The problem is that people in some uniforms do lie. I've seen it happen regularly. When I worked in manufacturing, I got exhausted with the lies of the management. They would lie to associates and expect the associates to believe them. And I could not participate in that because it was a lie. Now, there's different types of things in the world between lies and people who have privacy issues. Every human being on the face of the planet has private moments in their life. They have private aspects of their bodies. They have private aspects of their minds. They have private aspects of their souls and what they pray for. The problem we run into is when people start to believe that they have the literal right to get into other people's privacy areas, to literally ruin their legal documentation, to destroy their records on this planet, and to literally monkey around in their medical health. That is the lie they tell themselves, that they have been put in this planet to eradicate the world of the scourge of the earth, but no one gave them that little right. You see, the thin blue line might be an interesting concept, but what it says is we are Lord of all, and you're not Lord of all. You represent other people in the community. You represent politicians who put a person in place who literally then chose to hire you, and you literally represent the earth. Now, I've been walking in the community a lot of late because a police officer decided to impound my company car. They didn't really have the right to do it. I got permission to leave it at a Steak and Shake. The manager was kind of saying, "Hey, don't worry. It can be right here. You take your business, blah, blah, blah." The problem was that the plan was not to allow me to just have one night overstay. It was to destroy my life through the holidays. So, in fact, that police officer, illegally, female, in fact, took my car to an impound. Now the cost of that vehicle is much more than the vehicle is worth. And every time my car has gone to impound, which has been a whole whopping twice in my life in the last year because of some lying person, literally, they've destroyed my property. They stole my camera that my father bequeathed me in his death, and actually prior to his death, they ruined my paperwork for my materials that I sell for religious practices and rites, and they openly got into other things. They ruined clothing. I have someone who is literally getting into my storage unit where I'm paying a monthly wage. My family is paying it, but that doesn't make them the lawful owner of that particular case. It just means my mother is not willing to allow my $15,000 worth of home property that I've put aside for myself over the course of a lifetime of a man's life to allow it to be thrown away by some personnel who works there. That person does not own my property. They don't have any rights to it. They don't have the right to even open that door for any person whatsoever without a legal search warrant being presented to me. And since that hasn't happened, they have no lawful right to be in there. I personally went into that unit a little while ago. I personally reorganized the whole thing. Yet when I come back, I find a table that I was trying to care for to make sure it didn't get totally plowed and broken again. Literally was put back up in the wrong place. That means a person of some sort is getting into my unit. I have found all my organization disorganized. I found property damaged. I found papers that I was setting aside of my life history totally ruined. I will probably find my hard drives destroyed because some person thought they'd just play a game in my life. Now, who gave the person that right to do that? The Lord in heaven of all certainly did not. Jesus Christ did not step down from heaven and talk to that person and say, you're going to go into this unit, you're going to steal things, you're going to pilfer, you're going to sell things off, you're going to pretend like they weren't ever there, and you're going to ruin a man's life. I promise you, Jesus Christ and the Lord of all did not say that. Neither did Mother God, who is a proud figure in the history of our land, and yet pastors totally forget about her from the Bible because most pastors in churches appear to be men. There are some lady-led churches, but I can't promise they're doing all that well. I literally have been to several of late, and I'm absolutely flabbergasted that they still have the rights to that facility when they only have 20 members. Now, maybe they've long time held that building. Maybe it's more than paid for. Maybe that's why they can do it, but they're certainly not spreading the word of God if they've only got 20 members, and most of them are senior citizens who are really not networking and getting involved in the community whatsoever. Now, I can make a little fun, but then I can go and talk about the United Methodist Church. I have a pastor who represents my family's business there for more than 20, 30 years. We are founding members in that church, actually, one of the few remaining parents of that original set of pastors who are no longer there, not even married to each other anymore, and frankly, their children were hell on wheels. But that's not the point. The point is that when I talk honestly about the truth of life, that pastor and his staff literally manhandle the crap out of me when I call looking for a senior liaison who might serve the soul of my aged mother, who is so off track about the law on so many things that I think she's being manipulated in the facility in which she lives. Now, if I raise that question to the man in charge, what does he do? He throws me off the property. Now, what does that say to you? Guilty as charged, right? But openly, that is the problem, that when a person brings the truth to a company in a customer service-oriented way, saying, you really want to watch these employees, they are putting you in legal liability jeopardy, like late-night shifts at particular large box office or box stores, as we call them, the Walmarts, the Myers, and the Targets who have 24/7 hours, they really aren't paying attention to what those employees are doing. And that's really a shame. Because if they're going to leave the doors open and the lights on and the heat on for people to come in and shop, then every person should really be able to go in, window shop, make decisions about what they will and won't purchase, how much they will and won't spend, and if, for God bid, they sit down in a cafe that is set up for that little purpose on behalf of the overall organization, no manager has the right to walk over and throw somebody out just because they're sitting there. It's not loitering. If a person is eating the meal that they just purchased in the shop, that's not loitering. I actually had some less than 20-year-old Taco Bell manager imply that because I was sitting outside the Taco Bell on a freezing cold morning, mind you, literally waiting for them to open so I could eat breakfast, that I was somehow loitering. And I thought, how the hell am I loitering? I wasn't even using their Wi-Fi. I was making a recording for myself, but he was trying to imply that that was what going on. And I have to wonder, who are the people that are training these young people in management techniques? Not only was he rude and outlandish in his approach, but he doesn't get that I'm a customer service person in principle. I'm also a person who's a secret shopper just like every other human being on the face of any planet. You see, when a man or woman goes into a shop to spend hard-earned discretionary dollars, we are shoppers. We might be secret shoppers, and what that means is that literally we have the lawful right to pick up the phone and call a company and let them know how their employees are doing or not doing. More people will complain than give compliment. I learned from talking to a librarian who was used to getting complaints, but I told her how wonderful her staff was, how caring and kind they were. Literally, when I was there for about a week, getting some help on different resources that I needed for a legal situation, But in truth, when we're talking in ways that make sense, we have to really look at who is who in this land. Are we all people of the lie who lie all the time? Or do we personally have private information that is no one's right to disclose, no person's right to put in a legal record, and no person's right to manipulate in some way that every time you sit down in a place, some idiot, moron, shows up and starts to throw that information in your face in some way, shape, or form? Now, in my lifetime, I've had family destroy my right to privacy. I've had siblings cutting my clothing, ruining my property, stealing me blind, but their touting responses prove it. Any sibling that was not stealing things would say emphatically, "I'm sorry, I'm not doing that, and I'll help you to find who is." But when they don't offer that help, it pretty much implies their guilt to every other adult that I tell and share the stories to. The truth is, I've had so much happen in my life that some people don't want to believe it's true, and that allows them to monkey around in other aspects of a human being's legal life. That is improper underneath the house of the Lord, because the Lord knows who the liars are. You see, the soul is what goes home to heaven, and that's something that people don't remember. They all put it so much on physicality, on dress, on fashion, and all this material shit that we didn't start with in Adam and Eve times. They literally were butt naked in the forest, and that's how we began in life. And that is what will be returned to heaven, right? But the truth is, the bodies don't go to heaven. The soul does, right? So why is it that people get so wrapped up in the body aspect of a human being's life? You see, physicians want to say that my body is not my own, and that's not true. It is not their legal right to make a note in my file if I don't agree. That is my belief wholeheartedly. I am practicing religion that says you may not touch my body without my permission, and openly you may not medicate me either. Yet there are people who think they have the right to force you to do this. I've been forced to do that one time in life, and that man will pay for that dearly with his own license very soon. He was monkeying with people while I was there, but he couldn't monkey with me because I am a person of faith, and the Lord will not allow it. You see, when a person has got a strong faith, they are less manipulated by those who lie, steal, and cheat a person out of their rightful rights to their life. The people who are mentally unwell are the ones who cut people's clothing, who think they have the right to mob a person to death by involving other people in monitoring their lives, by involving total strangers in selling secrets about what a customer lawfully purchased with the privacy of their own funds. That's something we don't talk about a great deal today. That when a customer goes through a line, it is that customer's business, privately, what they purchased. We need to have a little bit more space between the people who stand in line is absolute truth. In Japan, there's a one-person-at-a-time attitude, that when you literally stand in line, the other people wait further back to allow you the privacy of your purchases. And that is the way it should be here in the land of the lost. You see, the land of the lost is the land of the lie. People lie all day long to protect their rights, to protect their time, to get out of difficulty situations, to pretend like they didn't involve themselves in someone's life to the extent that they did, to lie to say that they didn't parade a man through a closet in the dark in a skimpy skirt, and then they turn around and say that he did something to them. Not true. But what we have people who do those things. We have women who imply that they didn't possibly get into any intimate conversations with a man to the point that he wants to marry her, and yet that's not lawfully true either. So in life, we have certain people who lie. We also have people who imply that they have the right to make comment on other people's lives just because they're sitting across the way and they're voyeuring in on someone's life. They don't. They can hold their opinions between themselves and the Lord, but other than that, God is looking at them going, "Who the hell do you think you are judging someone else?" And that's the literal truth. There are people in this land who really feel that they have the right to manage, monger, mob, and destroy a human being's life because they don't agree with how they live their life, how they choose to dress, how they believe to feel, how they value their spirit, or where they like to attend church. What I can tell you is that the pastors in the Methodist realm really need to work on their outreach skills. I have been more than insulted several times by pastors who literally didn't get that I was going to that church looking for fellowship, looking for worship opportunities, looking for a way to get involved, looking for a way to be present with other people, and all they did was crap all over me because of how I looked, what I dressed like, the fact that I carried bags with me. Why? Because people were stealing me blind out of my car. Probably my family, probably my siblings illegally having copies of my car keys because some man who did the repairs gave it to them. Or they just decided to keep a copy because they thought they had some right to it, which they don't lawfully. It's a business car. Now my car is gone, and people think it's funny that I walk. What is a man supposed to do when police destroy a man's right to his vehicle? Or destroy his man's rights to his life in period? You see, that's what mobs do. They lie, steal, and cheat people out of their rights. they find out some private information and they decide that they're going to ruin a person's life and participate in ruining that person's life just to produce a new world that they want with people like them, not like everyone the Lord makes. You see, that's the sin of the land, that people think they have the right to decide what the Lord puts in someone's soul. And that's the slippery slope to evil, satanic worship. It says, I think I'm Lord over you, not the God in heaven is Lord over the soul. So we have this situation where we have a good percentage of the religious right, I believe is what it's called, that thinks they know God's plan for people's lives, that think that there's only a certain way that people are born. And I'm sitting there thinking, okay, if that's the truth, then why hasn't it been that way for a millennium? You see, the Lord produces all kinds of people. He produces men with fur on their faces in Italy. He produces children with tails. He produces men with all kinds of illness, women with all kinds of special needs. And yet, people think that God didn't make it all somehow. They literally want to say, that's not love, this is love. That's not intimacy, this is intimacy. Who the hell gave them the right to say that? And when I curse and swear like any human being does who gets passionate about a topic, then I look like I'm not possibly a pastor. No, I'm a realist. The realist says, I'm in control of what I say to the point that I allow the Spirit to speak through me. And when it does speak through me, it's my lawful right to share it. It's your right to decide whether you have an opinion on it, but who's really in the right place? If you've got gifts of the Spirit, then by all means, talk away at me. I'll be more than happy to listen. I've got a friend who I adore who has incredible gifts. She can stand right next to you and tell you every damn thing about your life, and you'd be flabbergasted. She'd get it 100% accurately correct. She'd also tell you who's good for you, who's bad for you, what man to get rid of your life, and she can do it in a matter of seconds. Why? Because she's been gifted since her childhood. Yet we have moronic pastors who think that gifts of the Spirit don't last in this world anymore. Who said that? Did it somewhere say in the Bible that God is not giving those gifts of the Spirit anymore? I don't think so. I really don't think so. But in truth, we have to listen to what people think, what people say, how they opinion their life. But here's the difference. When a person starts to demoralize another human being, starts to take away their rights underneath international human rights law, federal, national law, and other aspects of human dignities and civil liberties, that's when the monsters start to win in this earth. The monsters are the people who show up regularly without request, without permission, and sit around and voyeur and watch a person's life. They also steal property, they destroy records, they ruin a person's life history, and they think they're doing so somehow in the house of God? I don't think so. Here's what I know about the promise of God, that revenge is mine, saith the Lord. And when a person thinks they're going to lord over someone else's life, that revenge occurs. And what's absolutely fascinating is some of the most popular people in the world are actually people that the religious right would like to kill. Isn't that interesting that the Lord honors them above those who honor the idea of killing someone's life? Isn't that fascinating? We also have wonderful pastors like Joel Osteen and Joyce Myers and others who do a fabulous job of promoting God in a particular way. We also have another man named Dennis Whately who promotes God in a totally different way, to speak to the souls of other people. We have Deepak Chopra who talks about the Lord in a different holy way. We have the Dalai Lama who talks about the Lord in another way. You see, the soul is what the God in heaven promotes. And I had a Buddhist wife of many years, a spouse if you will, and she was more Christian than most of the people we met. And isn't that a fascinating concept? That I felt evaluated her skill sets, her ability to love, honor, cherish people, and laugh with them and care for them as more holy in her Buddhist ways than half the Christians I've met so far in my homeless journey. Now, this has been Blake Jensen of Blaze Communications, LLC, talking about the magic and mayhem of life. You see, the magic is what God does for people to keep them moving forward, to keep them honing their skills, to improving their craft, to going on with their talents, to knowing where to put their treasures, and literally their time. The mayhem is what people do who think they're in the house of the Lord, but they're really not. They're destroying lives. They're lying. They're stealing. They're cheating people out of their rightful life that the Lord has planned for them. And that's a slippery slope, because I don't know about you, but I don't want to be pitted against the Lord in heaven. It's like a David and Goliath situation. You're not going to win. God can outthink any human being. And if you think you can outthink the Lord, go ahead and try. I've seen people try and fail miserably in this land. Now, this may be an interesting podcast for some. It might be an annoying podcast for others, but I don't literally care, because I'm doing what I'm called to do, just like you in your own work. The difference is you get paid in a way that's different. I get paid in another way. And there are people who are trying to steal, rob, and cheat you out of your life, but are they in your family? Are they in your friend group? Are they in your social network? Or are they total strangers who just thought they'd attack your life because they can? They have the will. They have the power. They have the guns. They have whatever it is they think in their minds. The reality is they don't have the Lord with them, and that will be shown to them quite soon. So this has been Blake Henson again of Blaze Communications LLC talking about the magic and mayhem of life. Thanks for listening.